But playing the scales in a key and then breaking through, being able to transpose it to other keys, you know,
which is an absolutely unbelievable and incredible conversation for me to be having, because I never thought I would hear anything about it. Although I'm rather disappointed with my progress, I still got a hell of a lot of time.
What do you think?
I like it.
What do you make of it?
Well, I mean, what do I would shrug. I mean, normally I would think I'd shrug off the negative things you say about, you know, disappointed. But I don't. But I mean, the same with guitar. I completely relate to what he's saying. Like, I'm the same way as far as like. I wish I was a lot better. I mean, I don't know. I wish I was a lot farther along than I am, but I don't know. I don't know. Those are my thoughts.
You're teaching yourself too.
I've taught myself. Yeah.
I'm pretty much teaching myself.
Yeah.
So to take it slower. Anybody who has, I think, lessons and was allowed to stay with them, probably. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's something. I used to tell my kids the first day of school, get a sport and get an instrument. And now, you know, you need something to do that's meaningful. Get a sport, get an instrument, and now settle into learning. Mm. But because the sport would get you out of the dungeon, which is the last two periods of the day. If you, all the kids who do sports and activities are off campus with a bunch of other people having a hell of a lot of fun, with a hell of a lot of funds and a hell of a lot of support and respect, and then there's these latchkey kids and these kids that the counselors don't know what to do with get all their solid academics in the afternoon, you know, and all the kids who have, so. I told him, get an instrument, find something you love. Anyways, that wasn't the conversation you intended to have sitting down here.
Sounds finished.
Marvelous.
Sounds what?
Marvelous.
Marvelous.
Oh, okay.
Looking at these models.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the conversation started, by the way, with somebody who asked a silly question. A ridiculous and silly question. They said, "What would one of those crop circles look like if it was if it was musical?"
You know.
And so we started speculating on that.
What's interesting is that a light goes over these fields. That's all.
That's the phenomenon.
That's the phenomenon, and that's what results.
I've seen that. It's a flash. There's a guy. It's common in English, right?
Yeah.
And he put an all-night camera on it from a distance, and it just goes.
That's
like
right.
That. It's like lightning. That's all I ever see.
Did I ever tell you about
it's like a snowflake.
A TV show I saw one night about. I better not tell you how many years ago, but. It's probably at least 20. I wanted to see. It was on this one channel. And I ended up seeing two consecutive shows. And the first one was about sheep.
Fascinating.
And I found it quite fascinating because this film showed real shepherds at work. And once in a while, one of the sheep would get tangled into barbed wire and the difficulty of separating them. But his comment was, that's a sign that there's something wrong with the sheep, that particular lamb. And the content of the film was that in modern shepherding, they don't separate out those sheep that have brain damage or any other kind of physiological discomfort and illness. They just ship them all and put them on the food line and people eat them. Oh. But the last frames of this show, the author of it said, I wonder whether or not the fact that we're eating lamb that may in fact have disease, especially brain disease, may be a fundamental cause of, and then he listed all the diseases that moderns have that wasn't present 50 years ago. I said, geez, isn't that interesting? Okay, second show. This is a cameraman who goes around shooting marriages and things of that kind, local stuff. And he found that the screenshots, when he reviewed them, there was a streak. And of course, that made that particular frame not, he'd had to do something about that streak across it. And he said, wait a minute. I wonder what would happen if I blow that up. And successfully he kept blowing up that, especially at the point of origin, right? And it turned out that when he magnified it, it turned out to be always something that had a double wing to it, along a parallel line. But he said, what was curious about the line is that it could change direction instantaneously.
Okay.
And it even can go in circles. Say, what's this crop circle? A light goes over a field and creates this pattern. What? Can you put those things together?
It's a beautiful whirlwind snowflake of light. And it
it's
occurs.
Intelligible light. Think so?
Something makes it beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. With all of this stuff?
These for years have just, they're
right.
Yeah. Baffling.
Like, yeah.
But I have not studied them, but what I like about them is their recursive quality.
Yes, absolutely. Generated out of recursive properties, that's right. And some of them have three-dimensional qualities to them. Yeah. See, all we need to do is figure out what they could be symbolizing. That's all.
Yep, yep, yep.
That's it?
No, that's all. Apart from that, it's easy. Like, what is it? They're communicating.
Yeah. What are they saying, right? What are they,
the one in many?
What's the message?
Yeah. Yeah, must be.
Most of them have a remarkable symmetry to them.
Oh, yeah. They're awesome.
In balance.
Like, look at this one. Now there is a face. Look at this one. But look at the face.
That's an interesting face. It's almost got a certain clarity and nobility to it. It's not an awkward face. It's a very archetypical face. It's not a scary face.
There's some. I've heard that there was this people who have taken this cactus called the San Pedro, St. Peter. And when they've taken this, they say, they report that they fly. And so I'm wondering if, the ancients, like the people that made the Nazca lines, were somehow flying around and made those.
All we need to do is understand what it is they're doing. But that's remarkable, isn't it? I see.
Well, Pierre, I like the this. I think the story you've told us in the past about a crop circle.
Now, this is the first one I've seen that picks up like Buddhist imagery.
Buddhist.
See.
Oh yeah.
What's the Buddhist? Oh, the maybe the
illumination. Mm-hmm.
The Sumerians also had that of the eyes wide open.
Mm-hmm.
They have pictures of people, and they have just big old big. Mm-hmm. Empty eyes, but I mean they're just big.
Mm-hmm.
And those Sumerians were an interesting bunch of people. They lived around the mushroom, and their language was all based around the mushroom. And the mushroom was all symbolic of the male and the female genitals, and all their language was full of it.
Mm-hmm.
And the way they lived their lives and. It was all centered around the mushroom. And they're the ones that had those pictures of the people with their eyes wide open.
Well,
go figure.
What kinds of things can be communicated? Like what are the, is it possible to set up a group of categories for what the possibilities might be? Or are the possibilities endless?
Take one of Proclus's paragraphs and see whether you can render it into a figure that would represent the content. Because they have those interior dynamics.
Oh yeah, yeah. Especially Proclus, he lends himself to that all the time.
Yeah.
You can make beautiful diagrams if you take the time.
That's right.
Poetic.
Yeah.
So
artistic.
If that turned out to be the case, there could be a similarity. What would follow? They're doing Plato.
These guys are crazy, whatever they're doing.
Yeah.
I mean,
so much beauty. Right, so
like,
much beauty.
I mean, it's like a bit abstract, but it's like
left to that one.
There's a couple of them that are abstract like that, but that it seems almost like they're barcodes or something. It's like there's an order to them or something. That's an odd one. Say, gentlemen, in a few minutes, one of us is going to have to start folding up these tables.
Well,
and it's not going to be me.
Just one of us.
I think the latest.
And not me either.
And not me unless there's another person who does it with me. So I just wanted to make that point.
I had the pleasure of opening them up.
That's it.
I remember in the old days at the Women's Club on 10th Street.
Yeah.
We had some late nights talking with him.
But
I think the latest we ever went to in the old days, I remember, was I think we were pushing 2 o'clock once on a Friday night.
No. Well, what do we lock up the joint?
So the thing about the crop circles is that the same as with Plato. We have to bring ourselves to the understanding.
Absolutely.
They're just waiting for us, going, hey,
yeah.
Is there any sign of life down there?